By now, you're no doubt aware that there have been significant game-changing updates to After Effects 2023. Today, I'm going to show you three amazing updates that you may have missed. They're hiding right there in your animation presets behaviors folder, and they are awesome. Okay, so these new updates can be found in your Effects and Presets folder, Animation Presets, Presets, Behaviors. The first one we'll take a look at is Blinking Opacity, and it does exactly what you think it does. No more are the days of adding three opacity keyframes with values of 100, 0, 100, then Option or Alt clicking the opacity stopwatch and typing the expression loop out to get a blinking layer. Now you can do it, quite literally, with the click of a single button. Just select the layer and double click the preset. There are a few settings that are pretty self-explanatory. Max opacity is the brightest your layer will be, and min opacity is the darkest. Chances are you'll leave these values alone if you want something to blink on and off from 100% to 0%, or from full opacity to no opacity. Frequency per second is the setting you'll most likely want to play around with. You can set how many times per second you want a blink to happen. The higher the number, the faster your blink, because more blinks per second means faster blinks. This offset value is a little tricky, and I recommend you just leave it as is. The only thing you can't do with this preset is make your layer do a hard blink the way you would with hold keyframes, like this. But if a fading blink is what you're looking for, then this new preset was made just for you. Next on the list is a 2-for-1, and we'll be applying it to this simple rectangle path shape layer. Look over at our behaviors and you'll see two trim paths presets. We'll take one at a time, but by the time we get through the first one, you'll know exactly what the second one does. Double click trim paths at layer N. This preset adds a trim path to your shape layer with an expression. You have controls for how long in seconds you want the animation to last, as well as the path direction. What's cool is that this expression is based on where your layer begins, meaning you can trim the layer without losing the animation. Same thing goes for its partner, trim paths at layer out. Again, you can control the animation's length in seconds, the path direction, and the expression keeps your animation based on the out point of your layer, so trim away without losing the animation. A few caveats. Without keyframes, you have no easing options. And the one thing I wish the coders had included, hint hint Adobe, was an expression control for offset. As it is now, you can't control where the animation begins on the path. No matter how you size this rectangle, it will always begin in the upper right hand side. But if they just did something like expression controls, angle control, then link the offset to this angle control, this would give you control over where this animation would begin on the path, which I would find super useful. But hey, that's just me. Maybe they'll add that in the next update. At any rate, if you're looking for a simple trim paths animation on and off, give this preset a try. And I saved the best for last. I'll be adding this new preset to every single text layer the second I create it, lock anchor point. Double click this preset and by default, it puts your anchor point dead center in your layer. And you guessed it, it's locked. Check out the settings and you'll see all the options you have. Notice that as you move the anchor point location, your text layer moves around your comp, so you'll need to reset your position. Also important to know, since this preset is using an expression to lock your anchor point, your pan around tool will not work. Still, this is a great preset, especially if you always want your anchor point centered in your text. Keep an eye on my position, and you'll see that this preset allows you to add as many lines of text as you want, and your text layer will always remain in the same location. Now, I've done some research and I can't figure out what this when to sample does. Adjusting its value doesn't seem to have any effect on the expression, but that wouldn't make any sense, would it? If you have any idea what when to sample means and does, please let me know in the comments below and I'll address it in a later tutorial. But for now, this is one of my favorite new 2023 preset updates. So there you have it, three amazing new updated behaviors: blinking opacity, trim paths at layer in and layer out, and lock anchor point. Give all of these a try and you'll save a ton of time.